formal versus informal authority. People often ask me, what's the difference between formal and informal authority, and which do I feel is more important? Whenever someone is promoted to a leader position, there is usually a formal level of authority which comes with the role. So this is authority which is being given by someone senior, so invariably it comes from above. This authority is associated with the position. For example, you might be head of architecture, and in this role the holder has authority over such things as architecture decisions, directions, and all the staff within the architecture team. They have power and control over this area. With informal authority, this is not something which comes from being nominated to a formal position. This authority is usually bestowed by the people within the organisation. That is, it comes from below rather than above. Informal authority can be granted for any number of reasons: level of trust, level of expertise, personality, charisma, your characteristics. With informal authority, the holder becomes an informal leader within the organisation. They can play a critical role in the effectiveness of the organisation, as they may, at times, actually wield more power than formal roles. So which is better, formal or informal authority? Well, it's a tough question. Ideally, if we've got our talent management processes working correctly, then we should be promoting people who are already informal leaders, especially since they are probably trusted, have good expertise, are respected. This would then make their promotion understandable and more readily accepted by the team that they will look to lead. I always remember a line from the movie Braveheart when William Wallace is talking to Robert the Bruce about leadership. Wallace says to Bruce, "Your title gives you claim to the throne of our country, but men don't follow titles, they follow courage. Now our people know you, noble and common, they respect you, and if you would just lead them to freedom, they would follow you, and so would I." I agree with this statement. People don't follow titles. They might do what they're told, but they're just looking to follow orders. And this is not the same as really following a leader. With an informal leader, people had a choice and they chose to follow. With formal leadership, it's not really the same. And people, if given the choice, may choose not to follow you. I would encourage everyone who wants to be a leader to focus on developing their informal leadership skills. If you can do that, then you will show that not only are you ready to be a leader, but that people are ready to follow you. This is why, whenever possible, I try and implement leadership training at all levels within an organisation. I want people to start to learn leadership skills and put them into practice in their current role, whether there is formal authority or not. I'm always wary of people who wait to be appointed to a leadership position before they start to lead. I tend to see these people as people who are more interested in power and authority than actually leading. And in my experience, these types of leaders do not attract many followers. So both types of authority are important. And if I could choose only one, I'd take informal.